Let us now pray the Oratio Imperata for protection against COVID-19. Please all kneel. Merciful and compassionate Father, we come to you in our need to seek your protection against the COVID-19 that has disturbed and claimed many lives. We ask you now to look upon us with love and by your healing hand, dispel the fear of sickness and death, restore our hope, and strengthen our faith. We pray that you guide the people tasked to find cures for this disease and to stem its transmission. We thank you for the vaccines developed, made possible by your guiding hands. Bless our efforts to use these vaccines to end the pandemic in our country. We pray for our health workers that they may minister to the sick with competence and compassion. Grant them health in mind and body, strength in their commitment, protection from the disease. We pray for those afflicted. May they be restored to health. Protect those who care for them. Grant eternal rest to those who have died. Give us the grace in these trying times to work for the good of all and to help those in need. May our concern and compassion for each other see us through this crisis and lead us to conversion and holiness. Grant all this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not despise our petition in our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers. O glorious and blessed Virgin.
Amen.
Our Lady, health of the sick.
Pray for us.
Saint Joseph.
Pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel.
Pray for us.
San Roque.
Pray for us.
San Lorenzo.
Pray for us.
San Pedro Calungsod.
Pray for us.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins, let us beg God's forgiveness, and let us entrust ourselves to God's merciful love. Lord Jesus, you give us new life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you forgive our sins. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you feed us with your body and blood. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Grant us, O Lord, we pray, that the course of our world may be directed by your peaceful rule, and that your church may rejoice untroubled in her devotion. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Sirach. To keep the law is a great oblation, and he who observes the commandments sacrifices a peace offering. In works of charity, one offers fine flour, and when he gives alms, he presents his sacrifice of praise. To refrain from evil pleases the Lord, and to avoid injustice is an atonement. Appear not before the Lord empty-handed, for all that you offer is in fulfillment of the precepts. The just one's offering enriches the altar and rises as a sweet odor before the Most High. The just one's sacrifice is most pleasing, nor will it ever be forgotten. In a generous spirit, pay homage to the Lord. Be not sparing of freewill gifts. With each contribution, show a cheerful countenance, and pay your tithes in a spirit of joy. Give to the Most High as He has given to you, generously according to your means. For the Lord is one who always repays, and He will give back to you sevenfold. But offer no bribes, these He does not accept. Trust not in sacrifice of the fruits of extortion, for he is a God of justice who knows no favorites. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
To the upright I will show the saving power of God.
To the upright I will show the saving power of God.
Gather my faithful ones before me, those who have made a covenant with me by sacrifice, and the heavens proclaim his justice, for God himself is the judge.
To the upright I will show the saving power of God.
Hear my people and I will speak. Israel, I will testify against you. God, your God am I. Not for your sacrifices do I rebuke you, for your burnt offerings are before me always.
To the upright I will show the saving power of God.
Offer to God praise as your sacrifice, and fulfill your vows to the Most High. He that offers praise as a sacrifice glorifies me, and to him that goes the right way I will show the salvation of God.
To the upright I will show the saving power of God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Peter began to say to Jesus, "We have given up everything and followed you." Jesus said, "Amen, I say to you, there is no one who has given up house or brothers or sisters or mother or father or children or lands for my sake and for the sake of the gospel who will not receive 100 times more now in this present age, houses and brothers and sisters and mothers and children and lands, with persecutions and eternal life in the age to come. But many that are first will be last, and the last will be first. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear brothers and sisters, today we are being reminded of the necessity of being generous to God. God has been generous to us, and our response to the generosity of God is also generosity. And why should we be generous to God? Kapag ba tayo'y nagbibigay sa Diyos, ang Diyos ba ang talagang nakikinabang sa ating pagbibigay? Does God benefit from our generosity? When we are generous to God, my dear brothers and sisters, we are the ones who benefit from our generosity to God. Because those who are generous to God, God will also be generous to them. And this is what our readings today assure us. In our first reading from the book of Sirach, we are told, "Give to the Most High as He has given to you, generously according to your means. For the Lord is one who repays, and He will give back to you sevenfold." If in our first reading, the assurance given to us is that God will return our generosity to Him sevenfold, Jesus in our gospel today assures us even more, not only sevenfold, but 100-fold. Jesus said, "No one who has given up house or brothers or sisters or mother or father or children or lands for my sake and for the sake of the gospel that will not receive 100 times more now in this present age." My dear brothers and sisters, God cannot really be outdone in generosity. Hindi natin kayang talunin ang Diyos sa pagiging mapagbigay. If we are generous to God, God will be doubly generous to us. If we are doubly generous to God, God will be all the more generous to us. And so today, we ask ourselves, am I generous to God? How generous am I to God? When it comes to God, my dear brothers and sisters, may we not be stingy. Pagdating sa Diyos, huwag sana tayong kuripot. Pagdating sa Diyos, huwag sana tayong manghihinayang. Sayang ang oras ko, marami pa akong ibang pwedeng gawin. Sayang naman kung ibibigay ko yan sa Diyos, pwede ko namang ibigay sa iba. O kailangan ko rin naman. And we are not just talking of monetary generosity. We are also talking of our availability for God, our time, our presence, our attention, our consciousness. Are we generous to God or are we stingy towards God? tayo ba'y bukas loob na nagbibigay sa Diyos o tayo'y koripot pagdating sa Diyos? Baka pagdating sa ibang bagay, kaya nating magwaldas. Pero pagdating sa Diyos, naghihinayang tayo sa ating ibinibigay. My dear brothers and sisters, give to God and you will not be left unrewarded. Be generous to God and God will give back the blessings to you more than you expect and more than you can imagine. Aware of the danger in putting our trust in the pleasures of this world, we lift up our hearts in fervent prayer to the Father. For every petition, let us say, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Church throughout the world may be an effective sign of the way to everlasting happiness and eternal life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may learn to trust in spiritual values, which enrich our being and not in material possessions, which bring discontent to our souls. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may never close our hearts to those in need, but consciously involve ourselves in Christ's work of healing and reconciling. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the sick and the disabled may experience the Lord's care through the love of their neighbors and friends. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our deceased relatives and friends may enjoy God's peace in heaven. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray in silence for our personal petitions. Let us remember the people who need our prayers. Let us also pray for the intentions offered in this Mass. Heavenly Father, look with compassion on the needy. Enlighten our lives with your truth and give us the grace to live out the high ideals put before us by your Son, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may become acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
O God, who provide gifts to be offered to your name and count our oblations as signs of our desire to serve you with devotion, we ask of your mercy that what you grant us as the source of merit may also help us to attain merit's reward through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In Him you have been pleased to renew all things, giving us all a share in His fullness. For though He was in the form of God, He emptied Himself, and by the blood of His cross brought peace to all creation. Therefore He has been exalted above all things, and to all who obey Him has become the source of eternal salvation. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Broderick our Administrator and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Let us now pray to the Father as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold Jesus, the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Let us pray. Nourished by your saving gifts, we beseech your mercy, Lord, that by this same sacrament with which you feed us in the present age, you may make us partakers of life eternal through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.